Welcome to the English class. Today, in this lesson, I am going to talk about how to describe a graph. I hope this lesson will help you in answering the question number 14b in your GCO level English language paper. So, let's see what a graph is. You may heard about the graphs, you have learned about the graphs in your mathematics lessons. I am going to tell you what a graph is. A graph is a visual indication of data. What is this? Now, this is the Pramanya. Ogalanta kiyawanna pahasu wenna widiyata chithrayakin pennima thamai graph ekakin karanne. Me graph ekakin karanne datta tamanta daruwanta kiyawanna pahasu wenna widiyata denne. Right. When you are given data, they are given in many ways. Many different ways are used to draw graphs. They are bar graphs, pie charts, and line graphs. For the GCO level syllabus, these three are included. So, how do we collect data? Then we have to do a survey or a research. In your English paper, you find these two words. English prashna patra wala danatama puthala dakala athi survey ekak. Ewenata research ekak datta naththan pratipala thamai me data kiyala ubata denne. Me prashne di apata thiyena jargon ekak. Oy jargon eke moolika wacana deka thamai survey or research. මේ අපි සර්වේ එකක් කරන්න කොහොමද මේ බලන්න මම කරලා තියෙන සර්වේ එකක් නේද This is the result of a survey done in the class of 50 students about modes of transport used by them to travel to school يعني මගේ පන්ති ළමයි පණක් ඉන්නවා ඒ ළමයි පණගේ මම යව කොහොමද ඉස්කෝලේ යන්නේ කියලා ඒගොල්ලෝගේ උත්තර තමයි මම මේ data එකේ අරන් තියෙන්නේ These are the results Bus 18 students in my class come to school by bus. Then 4 students come by car. Then 12 students come by bicycle. So 10 students walk to school every day. Then other modes of transport are used by only 6 students. Other ways of transport means the modes of transport which are not mentioned here. Three wheeler or motor bicycle or something else, right? So let's see how this data is represented in a graph. This is the graph. Using that data, I have drawn a bar graph. This is when you see this, that putara terenuma ara table ekadiya balanota wada මේ graphic දිහා බලනකොට අපිට පැහැදිලිව මේක තේරුම් ගන්න පුළුවන්. ඒකයි මම කියවල් කලින්. It is a visual indication of data, right? So, අපි දන්නවා මෙතන bus කියලා තියෙනවා. This is the biggest one. අපි ගා ලොකුම bar එක තියෙන මෙතන. නේද? පුංචි එකක් තියෙනවා තව. ඊට වඩා ටිකක් ලොකු එකක්. එහෙනම් අපිට තේරුම් ගන්න ඕනවා. Right? Then මෙහෙම තමයි අපි බලන්නේ කොහොමද describe කරන්නේ? How to describe this bar? බාගාසක් ඩිස්ක්‍රයිබ් කරන කලින් මම ඔයාලට අවසරයක් කියන්න ඒකම අපිට පුළුවන් බා මේ පයි චාර්ට් එකක් ගන්න මම ඉස්සෙල්ල කිව්වනේ වර්ග දෙකක් තියෙනවා කියලා තුනක් තියෙනවා කියලා ඒ එතකොට බා ග්‍රාෆ් එකක තියෙන ඩේටාම ඒ විදිහටම පුළුවන් අපිට පයි චාර්ට් එකක් ගන්න This is a pie chart So numbers are given in these parts of the circle This is a circle So there are some parts Then color code is here It is the key. I'm giving you the key here, right? Bus, car, bicycle, on foot, and other. So you can easily understand what does it represent. So to describe this bar, make a better describe karan na. Monkey is a large one. You tell me, jargon. What kind of jargon do you mean? In describing a graph, you have to use some particular words. Look at this graph. When we graph it, you know, what does it mean? Axis. In your maths lesson, you have already learned these things, right? Y axis. मेरे पास क्या ना वाई एक्सिस के ना एक आप तवाक ना मत लियो वर्टिकल एक्सिस वर्टिकल आप क्या ना एक सिरा साक्ष्य वर्टिकल एक्सिस एंड दिस एक्सिस दिस इज कॉल्ड एक्स एक्सिस मैं कहता क्या नहीं एक्स एक्सिस ये मतलब हॉरिजॉन्टल एक्सिस एक आप क्या ना तिरा अक्ष गणन पाड़े में जाके क्या कहते हैं मैं राइट हियर दिस इज द बिगेस्ट टर्म मैं इसे के लोको में बाय करती हूं और एक इन अंदर ने वैल्यू में लाना है करना है तो मैं पाविच करना मोस्ट मोस्ट देखो तो कुदा में मतलब पाविच करना अधिक लीस्ट देन दिस टू आर इक्वल मैं तो समान है ये लिखते हैं समान है ना मतलब क्या इक्वल मैं देख मैंने मे ग्राफ मे बाय कर मैंने मेरे तरह ने बी एक तरह वड़ा वैडी तो वड़ा वैडी क्या है मैं पाविच करना मोर देन वैसे मैं बाय करना मैं के आड़ी तो लग पाविच करना वड़ा आड़ी क्या है ना लेस देन तो मैं वाचन कितना मतलब पाविच करेंगे ना आपको ताव वाचन कितना पाविच करें तो मैं वो सामान वाचन आती है आपके बारे में वो ना तो किला वैडी में प्रमाण है किस पर करना ना आपका वाचन है ना मोस्ट मैक्सिमम हाईएस्ट मेजोरिटी एक ऐसे वैडी में प्रमाण है आड़ी में प्रमाण है किस पर करना लीस्ट मिनिमम लोएस्ट माइनॉरिटी अपने में का सिंगल नेम होना थोड़ा तो जिसके अंदर आडू में आगर में मेरे के अंदर आडू में किया ना तो अपने माइनॉरिटी अगर क्या आप क्या ना सुलुतर है माइनॉरिटी सुलुतर है मेजॉरिटी बहुत है मैं ऑपोजिट वर्ड्स दिए ना तो इसका ऑपोजिट में मोस्ट लीस्ट मैक्सिमम मिनिमम कोई मां आगर हाईएस्ट लोएस्ट वैडी में आडू में मेजॉरिटी बहुतरे माइनॉरिटी सुलुतरे मैं ऑपोजिट टू दिस देन मेनी मोर के लिए देखा था मैं पाविच कर नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू टेल यू हाउ टू डिस्क्राइब हाउ टू राइट सम सेंटेंसेस अबाउट दिस ग्राफ दिस इज द देयर इज द ग्राफ दैट प्रीवियस ग्राफ सो लुक एट इट हमारा मोस्ट किन किससे होगा तो आपने इससे लगा कहीं ने लुक में बाय मतलब एक तो मैं पढ़ा आपने विभाग जी उत्तर दिया ने पटांगा ने पढ़ा अरे हमें जब पटांगा तो पढ़ा है एक ने सम लुक में क्यों पटांगा राइट मोस्ट ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स कम टू स्कूल बाय बस तो अगर मैं पढ़ा माला वे के लिए तब कता कराने अरे लापुन हाथली टोड़ा आडू වෙන්ගත ධර්මයන්ට තමයි වැඩිපුරම කතා කරන්න බලාපොරොත්තු වෙන්නේ. ඒ නිසා මම මේ බොහොම සරල වාක්‍ය ටිකක් අරන් දීලා ඔයාලට කියන්න පුළුවන් විදිහේ. Right? Look at them. Most of the students come to school by bus. Number 2, the least number of students come to school by car. Those are very easy words, right? 12 students come to school by bicycle. Look at the graph. 10 students here on foot. Only 10 students come to school on foot. But bus is the most popular mode of transport. मैं कहता हूँ most popular, least popular. Popular की वजह से मैं पाविच करती हूँ ना. Bus is the most popular mode of transport. Car is the least popular mode of transport. Only 6 students use other ways of transport. लामाई हाय दिने पामनाई मामे तो अन्य किन्ह वजह से पार्च करा. लामाई हाय दिने पामनाई मे अन्य वेनत मे प्रवाहन मामे पार्च कराने. Now look at the next one. In writing a description about a graph, you have to use some special phrases. So some important phrases I have mentioned here. Read them. The above graph shows. Then आप इधर ना हाँ, मैं वाले पर तू तारा देख लेती ना, मतलब दहाई दिन में पार होती हूँ ना, ऐसा देख लेती है ना. प्रश्न वाला दिन में the following bar graph shows. तो मुझे ना प्रश्न देना. मैं प्रश्न में आप इधर करने को ना मैं वाचन दी. आप इधर ना the above graph shows. ऐना तर the above graph depicts. The above graph illustrates. नतान अभी एम को तब तो मत करना था. This graph is about किट पटाने का पुलवा. इन नतान. This is a graph about किट क्या ना पुलवा. Then according to the graph, मैंने मेरे graph एक आनुवर. It is clear that मैंने मेरे आधा से पहले ही मैंने वो किताब लिया ना पुलवा. मेरे पाव बिच करने पुलवा. माँ केरा देना इस राजी. उन्होंने तभी बहुमत अभी मेरे पाव बिच करना. But in your writing, please don't write what you think about the graph or its data. Namme kiyana hetuwa api paper marking karanne dakala thiyena samahara daruna kiyena liyenawa watching television kiyana hobby ekak parichcha karala me godak kiyena. Ethara ape description eke api anthim kiyena watching television is a bad habit. Ehema liyenawa. E wage ewa apita awashya naha meka liyenawa. Right. When you write answering a when you answer a question, you have to plan your answer. You have, especially in writing question, in a piece of writing, there should be an organization. So you have to plan the description. When planning, I have divided into three groups. So introduction, main trend of comparison, conclusion. Then in introduction, what do you write? What is the graph about? Main graph එක මොකක් ගැනද? අපි මේකට introduction එකක් නැත්නම් හැඳින්වීමක් දෙනවා. What are the given data? මොනවද මේ දීලා තියෙන දත්ත? ඒක තමයි අපි මේකෙදි විස්තර කරන්නේ. ඒක අපිට 2-3 sentences are enough. අපිට කියන්න ඕනේ වාක්‍ය දෙකක් තුනක් විවහන ඇති පළවෙනි ඡේදය. Write what you can see in the graph. අනේ අපි දෙවෙනි ඡේදය තමයි කියන්නේ අපිට මොනවද මේ graph එකේ පේන්න තියෙන්නේ කියලා. Compare and contrast data. අනමහර ඉස්සර වචන ගන්නත් less than more than කියන්නේ. එතකොට අපි කරන්නේ මොකද compare කරන. මේ දත්ත compare කරන්න පුළුවන්. The conclusion එකදී අපි මේක ගැන නිගමනයක් ඉදිරිපත් කරනවා. ඒ කියන්නේ මේ දත්ත අනුව අපිට පැහැදිලි වෙන දේ. අපි ලියනවා මේ third paragraph එකේ. එතකොට අපි බලමු කොහොමද ලියන්නේ කියලා. This is a question taken from GC Oliver paper. This is from the GC Oliver paper in 2012. 2012 GC Oliver paper, question number 14B. Right? Read it carefully. The following bar chart shows the after-school activities of grade-level students of your school. Study the bar graph, bar chart, and write a description about it. Use about 100 words. අපි සාමාන්‍යයෙන් හැම ප්‍රශ්නයක්ම වගේ දකිනකොට use about 100 words කියලා. අපි වචන 100ක් වගේ ප්‍රමාණයක් ලියන්න ඕනේ. ඒකට මෙතන තියෙන chart එක දිහා බලනවාම there is a topic after school activities of graduate students of your school. දැන් මේක පාවිච්චි කර මේක දිහා බලලා මේක තියෙන වචන ප්‍රයෝගී කරගෙන අපිට පුළුවන් මේ වචනම use කරලා මේ description එක ලියන්න. දැන් තියෙනවා දීලා උදව් කරපොනි. හැම paper එක හැම ප්‍රශ්නකම ඔයාලට මේ උදව් කරනවා paper එක හදන්න. The following words will help you. මෙන්න මේ වචන වල උදව් වෙයි. වචන මතක නැත්තම් වචන ටිකක් දීලා තියෙනවා. Most of the students, the lowest number of, least popular, most popular, more popular than, minimum, maximum. ඉතින් අපි මේක කිව්වම the following words will help you. අපිට මේ සේරම වචන ලියන්න ඕනද? නෑ. You can use the words very important to this question or the words you need to write this description tamanta avashya wacana tika vitarak thoraganna right okkoma liyanna avashya ne ekaṭa if you so I suggest you to write the description post the video and write description with your teacher then teacher will correct your answer and again see the my answer right This is the answer I have written. Introduction, description, and conclusion. There are three parts, right? You can read this. I don't read this here. You can read the post the video and read it carefully. In the first paragraph, look at this. There are only few words written in black. Why is it? I have written all the words found in the paper in red color. බලන්න මම දෙන තියෙන රතු පාටෙන් වචන ගොඩක්, කළු පාටෙන් විතර ටිකයි. ඒ රතු පාටෙන් ලියපු වචන ඔක්කොම මේ ප්‍රශ්නයේ තුලම ගලිනවා. ඒකයි මම කියන්නේ මම දරුවන්ට හැමදාම කියන්නේ මේ bar graph එක විස්තර කරන එක හරිම ලේසියි. මොකද මේකට අවශ්‍ය කරන වචන ටික ඔක්කොම paper එකේම තියෙනවා. දැන් අපි දරුවෝ සමහර දවල්ට ප්‍රශ්න පත්‍රය අරගත්තාම ලියන ප්‍රශ්න දැක්ක ගමන් හිතනවා මේක හරිය අමාරුයි ගොඩාක් ලියන්න තියෙනවා ඒක නිසා ඒක කරන්න එක අතාරින්න එහෙම කරන්න එපා මේක හරිය ලේසි කියන්න මේ වචන සේරම ඔයාලගේ graph එකේම තියෙනවා ප්‍රශ්නෙම තියෙනවා නම් මම පළවෙනි එක කියන්නම් the bar graph shows the after school activities of regular students of our school බලන්න අපි මෙතන ප්‍රශ්න දී බලමු කියලා මේ ප්‍රශ්නේ බලන්න මෝ The following bar chart. The following bar chart के लिए following के नाम जिन्हें क्या हुआ? The bar chart. ये जो थी ना shows the after school activities of regular school students of मित्र थी ना your school. Your के लिए why लगा हुआ मामा school. हाँ क्या है सी? पहले निवास क्या पढ़ी हुआ? ये पास अभी second sentence है क्या? The vertical axis. दरवारा ते जन्ना why axis के लिए बात प्रश्न है. Axis shows the number of students. The horizontal axis shows the after-school activities. इतना वाटर टिकर मेथड क्या है ना मैं इतना after-school activities की है ना उधर जो मात्रक थी आप बोलते हैं ना y-axis, x-axis के अंदर क्या इतना है मैं वाटर टिकर थी ना sports, read books, visit friends, gardening, watching TV ये बातें हैं तो बट आप ही तेरो कह रहे होंगे मैं प्रश्न लिया है ना सियालू में आवश्यक देवल प्रश्न है तुलना में तीन ए भी दिया था मामा एक ही मारा गया ना बात दिया थी मैंने मेरे दिया बोले मोस्ट ऑफ़ द स्टूडेंट्स विजिट फ्रेंड्स आफ्टर स्कूल ईच एंड एवरी वर्ड इज़ फाउंड इन द क्वेश्चन इट्सेल्फ राइट हियर मैं बोले मैं तो दिया मोस्ट ऑफ़ द स्टूडेंट्स नहीं मोस्ट ऑफ़ द स्टूडेंट्स मैं तो After school, हरे लेसी दिया, नहीं अभी पालो में लग रहे हैं ना, उतारो में का study करें ना, teacher के का में का video का post करेंगे ना, में का किया वाला, में के कौन तो sentences लिखा थी निकला पाले ना, इलाके में हम, then mark लोग ऐसे लग, अभी लाखों हाथ में का doing करने दरवान का ही में का focus करें, हमें मामे ये जो डाटी का advance लिया तो पुराने दरवान का, तब आंसर था clear थी ना, look at this, you can read this, you can go through this and learn how to write. So, I am going to tell you how to give you marks. So, marks are allocated. 10 marks are allocated for this question. Or the 10 marks content. Adavu karunote 3 marks there. Then language 3 marks. Organization 2 marks. I have explained that explained about organization earlier. Mechanics of writing. I will tell you what they are. 2 marks. So all together 10 marks. So look at this. Content. Mukhaat kumye adhaan kudhe ki anne. Ekata kohamata api denne lakuntu. Me lakuntu na api vedana vena kramamata. Correct interpretation of the graph or the information included. Siyanumatara tu adhaan kudhe ni honi. Me interpretation kati kena vishtare nivayar dhe ni honi. Correct interpretation. Total full marks samdhe. 3 marks. Then 2 marks are given when it has written on you have written on most of the information methane thoraturu poda vadi kula pramana dilla thiyena correct interpretation nivara diva dilla thiyena avashya pramanaya bohomayak dilla thiyena ekaṭa api kalpana karanne ekak deka missuna thabbe lakunu deka kamana ekaṭa eka man kiyanne meka lesi interpretation not sufficient me vistare apita pramanavak madi enamuth api dilla thibbot एक लाखुना देना है क्योंकि वो आलम पुला मालूम गाड़ी ले बहुत मना रही कहीं कहीं तक तो एक लाखुना खो गई है लुक एट दिस लैंग्वेज राइट 3 मार्क्स ऑलमोस्ट नो एरर्स ऑलमोस्ट में मैं बात लेकर आ गया एक है अपने बड़ा को रुक पे ने सीए तो सीए को नहीं मेरा दी के ला ऑलमोस्ट नो एरर्स क्या नहीं වැරදි නැති තරම. ඒකට චූටි වැරද්දක් තිබුණා මේ ලකුණු තුන අම්මන. Well connected sentences, good range of vocabulary. එතකොට හොඳ vocabulary එකක් තියෙන නන්නට අපි කියපු වචන පාවිච්චි කරලා තියෙනවානේ. You have to use the jargon of this question, right? Some errors, well connected sentences, good range of vocabulary. Then 2 marks. Some errors are there but you can get 2 marks. Then only a few correct sentences. If you can write few sentences, 2-3 sentences correctly, you can get 1 mark for language. So, all the sentences, if all the sentences are incorrect only, you get 0 marks. So, if you study this well, you can write at least one to two, three sentences correctly, so you can get one mark for this category. Then the organization. Well organized ideas, connected meaningful paragraphs. So we have to connect, we have to separate the, organize the writing in paragraphs. So we have to write in paragraphs, and ideas should be well organized. Again, after arayam meaning liyanne ba samahara daru mulin liyanne one ka apita liyena apita liyanne mulata ehema ba hal piliwalata ara man kiyala thik piliwalata liyanne. So you can get 2 marks for well organized ideas, connected meaningful paragraphs. Or 1 mark for ideas not well connected. If the ideas are not well connected, but not connected, you will get 1 mark. So the mechanics of writing. What are these? Well, mathematics are spelling errors. Mechanics of writing can be argument more than that. You have spelling errors. Correct punctuation. When you are writing a list, you have to use commas and full stop and the capital letter. When and where necessary, you have to write capital letter in order. So handwriting clear, but errors in spelling and punctuation. Punctuation number one, spelling errors one. Handwriting clear, clear the another one mark come. Right? Ena. අපිට තේරෙනවා මේ හැම කැටගරියකටම එක මාර්ක් එකක් ගන්න ගන්න එක ලකුණ ගන්න ගන්න තෝරන්න අඩුම ගානේ ලකුණ at least you can score 4 marks for this question so that is something is better than nothing you know ඒ නිසා අපිට ලකුණු හතර ඉතම වැඩ so I am going to wind up this lesson I hope that your teacher will help you in learning this more please answer more questions found in past papers and term test papers. So I hope it will help you in answering the question number 14B in your English paper at GCSE O level examination. So I hope to meet you again in another video. Thank you very much for being here.